Are you pregnant? Have you already watched the movie What to Expect When You're Expecting? Well, Hollywood doesn't always get it right, so today we'll be reviewing that movie, some scenes from it, in detail. Hi, my name is Emily. I'm a midwife working here in Cambridge. Canadian midwives provide prenatal, intrapartum, and postpartum care to our clients. And today we will be watching a few scenes from the movie What to Expect When You're Expecting, and I will be reviewing them as a midwife. Point to make is that no two births are the same, and Hollywood doesn't always get it right. So certainly if you are pregnant, talk to your healthcare provider if you have any questions about the specifics of what we're going to be going through today. So today I'll be watching one of the storylines from the movie What to Expect When You're Expecting. Make sure to tune in to our other videos where other midwives at our practice will be reviewing the other storylines involved in this movie.
Everyone's favorite tough love trainer from the weight loss show, Lose It in Week.
Oh my God, I think I'm gonna throw up.
We got this, we got this, okay?
We can do this.
Just one more dance, one more dance.
We know how to do this.
Jules Baxter and her partner, Evan Weber.
Obviously, we know this is a movie about pregnancy. The fact that she said that she's feeling nauseous is making me suspicious that maybe she is pregnant and now she's about to do some sort of risky dance number with a partner on national television. I'm excited to see where this storyline goes.
Jules Baxter and Evan Weber.
Oh, she won. Look at her go. Okay, she's not looking so great now. Oh no. Okay. So sometimes if you weren't planning on getting pregnant or if you haven't missed a period yet, sometimes that unexplained morning nausea or even nausea that happens throughout the day, though we talk about it being morning sickness, it doesn't always happen in the morning. So sometimes that's one of the earliest symptoms that people notice of being pregnant is, well, why am I being sick every day? Why is this happening to me? Okay, maybe I should take a test. So that's where I'm kind of thinking Cameron Diaz's character is going to be going now.
Are you sure you're not freaking out? Seriously, I mean, just say so. I can handle it.
A freak out's a little strong.
I really thought I had a bump fallopian tube. I just don't want to force it.
Hey, crazy. I wanted to be with you before you were pregnant. This just...
There we go. Okay, so she is pregnant.
A lot.
What are you going to do about your show?
Well, we start filming in 3 weeks, and I'll be finished before I have to deliver. So basically, I am going to be helping people get thin while I get fat.
Every single person gains weight in pregnancy. It's not just you. It's not just your body weight. You are growing a baby inside you, and your body needs to make some changes to allow that to happen. So weight gain is normal in pregnancy, but certainly it can be something that some people struggle with a lot.
Your blood pressure is low and you are in good health and Dad's gonna keep you that way, right?
Right.
Uh-huh, look at these pamphlets.
Ooh, thank you.
Uh-huh. Cameron Diaz's character is having a check-in with her healthcare provider, whether it's a midwife or a doctor, we're not sure. Her healthcare provider said that her blood pressure is low. That is fairly common in pregnancy, especially when somebody is starting off pregnancy as slim as Cameron Diaz's character is.
That's all we need to know. Let's not go crazy with the research.
I love research. It soothes me.
Well, then you will love the wall. I will see you both in a month.
Wow.
What? Oh, no.
I don't want to know about everything that can go wrong.
Oh, my God.
They're talking about research. That is a huge part of midwifery care. A lot of what I spend my day doing is telling people, here is option A, here is option B, this is what the research says about both. What decision would you like to make?
It's okay, there's breastfeeding, we have to know about this. Cord blood banking, this is very important these days, and you need to learn the Bradley method.
Right.
And what? Oh, circumcision, yes or no?
Of course, how is that even a question?
Circumcision is obviously a big conversation to have as well. That's one we tend to have towards the end of pregnancy, assuming that either we don't know the sex of baby or know we have a baby boy on board. The Canadian Pediatric Society, so the Pediatricians of Canada recommend that circumcisions are not medically necessary right now. So if people are planning on circumcising their baby, there is a fee to pay for it, and there is no medical reason for it. That being said, we understand that there are a lot of cultural and religious groups where circumcision is a part of their belief system, and we support those people in making those choices as well.
Actually, a lot of couples are choosing not to circumcise these days. Interesting.
Who said that?
The expert, honey. Clearly, there's a question. That's why it says yes or no.
My answer is yes, yes, yes.
My answer is I need to read about it.
Us here at Cambridge Midwives, we have a lending library of books. We have pamphlets available that your midwife can get for you. And we also have a lot of handouts from our association, the Association of Ontario Midwives, that provide a lot of client-specific information on a lot of these big topics that we always talk about.
We want it to be a surprise.
It's okay. We don't have to say.
Evan, I'm pregnant. That's surprise enough. We want to know.
It's a boy.
Oh,
boy.
Oh, that's so cute.
Okay, so they just had an ultrasound. Ultrasounds are something that are quite frequently done in pregnancy. With somebody who's having a low-risk pregnancy, typically people will have three ultrasounds, four ultrasounds is kind of the baseline. One typically early pregnancy that tells you when you're due, so it gives you that due date. One sometimes a few weeks later if the partner and the client are deciding on doing genetic screening. And then the most in-depth ultrasound, which is probably being done here, is what we call the anatomy ultrasound. So during that ultrasound, which happens around 20 weeks or so of pregnancy, baby is looked at from top to bottom, head to toe, every single structure. And that's when the technician, or I guess in this case, it looks to be the obstetrician, could determine the sex of your baby. But once again, it's not always 100%. So we as midwives do not do ultrasounds in clinic. For clients of ours that are wanting to have ultrasounds, we provide requisitions for them to get those ultrasounds done in the community, in some cases in the hospital, and then we talk with our clients about the results of that ultrasound, any follow-up, any recommendations, all those sorts of things, after that ultrasound report comes back to us.
Great. If you're
can
right.
Hurry this up? He's pushing on my bladder.
Great. All right. We got it.
Okay, but did you get my rack? Because I'm going to need evidence that I have these.
We got proof.
You got it?
Okay. Yes, that's great. Thanks, Jill.
Those changes are real, so you can see, obviously, she's got a bump, and then she's also talking about her breasts being fuller and wanting to make sure that those are being documented by the camera, which is funny, but that is also a truth of pregnancies. That's one of the things that does tend to change for people in pregnancy. The pregnancy-related hormones cause your breasts to increase in size so that when baby is born, we have, you know, an ample supply of breast tissue so that if you are planning on breastfeeding, that option is there.
This is great.
Thank you.
We are so excited to have you as our spring cover mom.
Me too. Listen, can we just try to keep it positive? You know, there's a lot of articles out there that make women over 35 who are pregnant feel like crap.
Right.
And one thing I always like to mention is every person and every body needs different things in pregnancy. Whether you're starting off pregnancy at the age of 40, whether you're starting pregnancy at the age of 17, those two different bodies need two different things in pregnancy. When it comes to folks who are over the age of 35, we understand that there are higher risks of things like Down syndrome, higher risks of miscarriage, for example. We understand that there are different risks. And because of that, it's important that your healthcare practitioner talk to you about those risks. So if you are pregnant or planning on getting pregnant and you are over the age of 35, your healthcare practitioner will talk to you about those risks and plan your pregnancy accordingly.
I can't get someone else to fly around and do these interviews. I don't like you traveling this late.
Well, nobody's asking you to stop doing your job. Besides, these are my contestants, Evan. I was there when they lost the weight and I want to be there for them now.
It is safe to travel in pregnancy. We understand that there are some risks to sitting down for too long, and sometimes the pressure differences when you're flying can impact you when you're pregnant. So if I had a client who was pregnant, an uncomplicated pregnancy, let's reiterate that, I would say something like compression stockings or making sure they're getting up and walking up and down the aisle of that plane every hour, if that flight is anything longer than 3 hours, would be my recommendation. And then we also understand that people who are getting close to term typically shouldn't be flying, and various airlines will require slips from healthcare providers saying, yes, this person is safe to fly if they do look heavily pregnant as they're boarding that plane.
I just think someone should go with you and little Jackson there.
Well, you know what? I have my crew, and you are welcome to leave your show and come along. We are not naming him Jackson.
Wait, you liked it last week.
Obviously, you caught me in a moment of weakness. Honestly, God, I seriously sometimes I think that it'd just be so much easier if I could do this on my own.
Really? You think that?
So that was a heavier hitting clip. And certainly that's not abnormal in pregnancy. I always make a point of mentioning that not only does your body change physically in pregnancy, you change emotionally and your relationships change too. Even the most solid of long-term relationships, that dynamic changes when you're pregnant because you are throwing a third little person into that mix.
You and I are gonna do it together, Gary.
Okay.
You and I, here we go.
All
we're
right.
gonna do lunges, ready? And I wanna deep, let me squeeze okay. back up. One more, come on in. Let's go. Oh, God.
Oh my God, Jules.
Oh my God, oh my God.
Ooh, okay. I make the point of mentioning that exercise is safe and recommended in pregnancy. So though this scene made it look like you're going to do two lunges and then fall over, that's in reality not what typically happens. I talk to my clients about understanding that if you've never trained for a marathon before, pregnancy is not the time to start. But if you have been physically active before your pregnancy, continuing to be as physically active towards the end of your pregnancy makes your pregnancy shorter, makes your labor shorter, and has a bunch of other good outcomes with regards to baby as well.
The hospital said that I could fly pretty soon.
Nice try. You need to stay in bed so we can keep your contractions under control.
Ah.
You're having this baby in Atlanta.
You don't understand. I have to get back to LA. I have to finish my show.
And what? Have your water break at 30,000 feet?
Ooh.
I climbed Everest, okay? I'm pretty confident I can keep this baby in until I get home. I can do that, okay? I can do it.
No, you can't. You need to stay in bed. Honestly, you don't have a choice.
So, obviously, what they're trying to tell us here, I'm imagining, is that that sudden lower abdominal pain that she had while doing those lunges was actually a contraction. I'm not believing that, to be completely honest. I think this is probably one of those liberties that Hollywood sometimes takes to take a movie from kind of blah to something way more exciting. Typically, when we're talking about preterm labor, which assuming that that's kind of what's going on here by the sounds of her being put on bed rest, typically preterm labor doesn't start as one whoppingly strong contraction out of the blue. Typically, if somebody's going into preterm labor, it starts with small rhythmic contractions that feel like a menstrual cramp or sometimes can feel like back pain. And sometimes it starts off so subtly that people don't know they're in preterm labor. The chances of a circumstance like Cameron Diaz's situation happening where you're fine and then all of a sudden you're doubled over in pain is a little less likely. Certainly it can happen, and if you are having concerning cramps in your pregnancy that aren't going away, that's something to talk to your healthcare provider about.
Hey guys!
Hi, Jules!
I'm sorry I can't be there. I just wanted to congratulate you all on working so hard. And forget about what the scale says tonight. You're all winners. Son of a bitch!
Jules, we're live!
Fuck!
I've heard every single possible swear word said in labor. It takes a lot to make a midwife blush, and you can say whatever you need to get through that pain.
We're here, Jules.
I don't care about his penis. I don't give a shit. We're having a
Okay, so obviously now we're at the hospital. It's hard to say if she's term or if she's not, but I'm assuming this pregnancy is probably her with a full-term pregnancy. So her partner is wheeling her in extremely fast to the hospital. And that is sometimes the reality. I've you know, been in circumstances like that where we're rushing into the hospital to deliver a baby. Certainly the benefit of midwifery care, which is slightly different than how most obstetricians work within Canada, is that if you are a midwifery client and you think you're pregnant, you don't have to go to the hospital when you think you're in labor. You actually get the benefit of getting to call us first. So what that does is it allows you typically to save a couple of trips in and out of the hospital, because if it's your first pregnancy or even if it's your fifth pregnancy, it's really hard to know when those contractions are long, strong, and frequent enough to truly be making change to your cervix that are putting you into what we call active labor. So that period of time where your cervix is making change, baby is descending into your pelvis, that eventually results in them being born. But here in Cambridge, we have the benefit of having a beautifully new birthing wing of the hospital. It's fantastic. So if somebody was to page and I was to tell them, do you know what? Yeah, it does sound like you're in labor. Let's go and have an assessment and see if ready to have this baby, we would meet in obstetrical triage. So that's on the first floor of the hospital, the newer side of the hospital. Right now, it is the COVID-19 pandemic, so there is some screening to do before we can all get into the hospital together, which is actually helpful because it means that we have a whole bunch of wonderful volunteers who are great at guiding people towards where they need to go. So if you show up to the hospital huffing and puffing in labor, the volunteer will still ask you the COVID screening questions. Then they can also wheel you in the wheelchair towards where you need to go so you're not going to get lost, which is great.
I know you.
I could do it.
That's it. With your help, I've lost 8 pounds.
Can you help me do the same?
Okay, so 1 to 10
has
pain right now.
2.
All right, tough girl.
Give me 3.
Everyone's pain scale is different, and for most people, labor is the most painful experience that they've ever had. So it's really hard to compare, you know, what previous experiences might be like to something that you have no real idea of what it's going to happen or how it will kind of unfold or what that pain is even like, because obviously stubbing your toe is much different than, as Cameron Diaz's character said, trying to lose 8 pounds rather quickly.
You're at 8 centimeters.
Good. 2 more. I can push.
So right now, Cameron Diaz's character is in what we call transition. So the period of about 8 to 10 centimeters is sometimes the most unsettling time during labor. It's the time where we typically hear the phrase, I can't do this anymore, because your body is getting so ready to push out that baby.
Say I can do it. Yeah.
I can do it, but I can't do this.
All right, so firstly, I'm so pleased to see that actually squat bar up there. So that's an attachment for labor and delivery beds that allow different position changes. Cameron Diaz's character obviously doesn't have an epidural, so she's having a natural childbirth, and she is utilizing different positions with the help of gravity that can make that labor shorter and can make pushing easier. One thing that always grinds my gears in movies and TV shows about birth is how they depict pushing. So they were telling her to push, and here she is talking through that contraction. Typically, when somebody is pushing out a baby and pushing effectively, we tell them to take a big, deep breath in, hold that breath, hold all of that noise inside, and then push everything down. If you are sitting there saying, I can do this, I'm pushing, you're not using enough energy to actually move your baby closer towards being born at the end of the day. Cameron Diaz's partner is starting to look a little bit frantic and a little scared. And that's also a reality of being in labor and pushing out a baby, because quite often partners don't see the pregnant person or someone they love that much in that much pain. And that can be really hard to see for some people. So we like to make sure that not only is a pregnant person doing well, but the partner's doing well as well.
And push.
That's good. All right. And it's a girl.
Yay. Wait. First of all, I was right in saying that ultrasounds are never 100% on baby sex, because they thought they were having a boy this whole time we were talking about circumcision, and behold, we're having a baby girl.
Oh, there she is. Hi. Hey.
They already had an umbilical clamp on baby's umbilical cord when they were handing the baby up to Cameron Diaz. In reality, and especially here in Canada, we understand that the benefits of waiting for that umbilical cord to stop pulsing before you clamp and cut it is really beneficial to babies. So unless we have any reason to be concerned about how baby's transitioning to breathing, so if they come out what we call floppy and blue and need some help with breathing, then we would clamp and cut that cord fast. Otherwise, typically we're bringing baby up onto someone's chest with that cord still attached and waiting for it to stop pulsing. And then also, Hollywood never, ever, ever gets babies right in terms of coming out covered in goop and goo. I would be very surprised if a baby came out of somebody looking that clean. All right, so that's it for our video today. A couple of things to mention that this movie doesn't cover is postpartum care. So that's one huge difference between, for example, the way that we as Canadian midwives provide care as opposed to how obstetricians provide care. So one of the things that I stress wholeheartedly to friends and family of mine who maybe aren't quite as sure as what a midwife does and how we might be similar or different than various doctors in the community, is the postpartum care. One of our tenets of care is that we will come to your house postpartum to make sure that baby's gaining weight, you're doing well, give you all those breastfeeding tips and tricks that you might need if breastfeeding is what you're wanting to do, and to offer that support in a really personalized way. One thing I will also stress as we finish this video is make sure to like and share this video with other people who either are pregnant or maybe planning on getting pregnant. And certainly if you are living within the Cambridge Waterloo area and are pregnant or are planning on getting pregnant sometime soon, feel free to check us out on the web at cambridgemidwives.ca. And remember that this is also a space to ask questions, but if you have any specific questions as they relate to your healthcare, relate to your pregnancy, those are questions that are best addressed by your healthcare provider. So thank you for watching, and make sure to check out the other videos that we have about other midwives reacting to the various stories in this movie. Okay, thanks, bye.